We are going to be talking about 3D printing today, from part design to slicing and printing it using two different kinds of 3D printers, a regular tried and true FDM printer and my new toy, Anycubic Photon Mona 2 SLA resin printer. This is not going to be one of those 0-to-hero 3-hour videos on 3D printing. Instead, I want to focus on a very specific situation I get a lot when working on my projects. And I know other people have ran into this too, because I googled it. You found something on Thingiverse or any other popular website for 3D file downloads. It's great, it's perfect, but maybe the dimensions are wrong. Or you don't have that specific kind of a motor or a controller. What do you do? I added software engineers in the title of the video. I'm not a mechanical engineer or 3D designer, and I honestly don't have a talent to be one. So we're going to use the easiest tool that worked for me, Tinkercad. Download the model you want to edit. Then go to Tinkercad and create an account if you don't have one yet. Then press on Create 3D Design. Give it some better name. Import your STL file. This is the chassis for the Smart Spider robot that I recently made. There were a few things that I wanted to fix here. First of all, I didn't need any of the holders for the motors or the holes for the motor shafts. Also, I needed the chassis to be slightly wider to accommodate the expansion board that I wanted to fit inside. So we have the three situations: remove stuff, add stuff, and modify dimensions. Removing stuff by far is the easiest. Click on the hollow box element and drop it on top of the model. Adjust the size so it would cover all the parts that you don't need. Watch out for making the box either too small or too big. You can set snap grid to off and then use the keyboard buttons for very fine grain movement. Once you're done resizing and moving the hollow box, use Shift to select both model and the hollow box, and then merge them together. You will see that the parts of the model that were inside of the hollow box have disappeared. Now check if you did too much or too little. If this is the case, undo the merge step, resize the box, and merge it again. It won't be perfect, although here I could have spent a little bit more time adjusting these parts, but we don't need it to be perfect for now. The best way to support this channel is to buy something with affiliate links, which you can find in the video description. I only promote things that I personally have bought and found them to be of a good quality. Or you can become a patron on Patreon for some cool perks. Now we want to fill in the motor shaft holes. Instead of choosing the hollow element this time, we choose a regular cylinder. We can also choose the box, but the hole is round, so place it where the motor shaft hole is and resize it to fill the hole completely. Use the same technique as in the last step. We have four holes, so after checking on one, copy and paste it with Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to the other three. After you have all four cylinders in the right places and the right size, use the Shift or simply select them all and the main model, then merge them together. And check the result. Finally, we want to modify the dimensions of the parts. This is the trickiest because we want to know exactly by how much to modify the dimensions. We don't want to print it and then find out it's too small or too big. Fortunately for you, you can find STLs for many electronic components on the internet. The expansion board I wanted to use for the robot is about the same size as Arduino Uno R3, so I'll just download that STL file and import it to the project. We place the board at the designated location. And then make the chassis wider. Press Alt button for uniform scaling, so the part will be scaled from the center in two directions. Then export the final STL file. As I mentioned before, I have two 3D printers. One is older Wanhao Duplicator 4S, which I bought secondhand here in the Netherlands. It's a decent, reliable machine with dual extruder system, but I found it does not do fine details well. So I decided to give it a try to a resin printer. By far the cheapest option on the market at the moment is Anycubic Photon Mono 2. With some discount codes and during the promotion campaigns, you can get it for less than $150. After using it for a bit of time with Anycubic water wash resin, I found that it's a solid beginner tier resin printer. Nothing too fancy, but does the job very well. The only thing I would want to add to this little printer is remote control, because I'm so used to having it with my FDM printer. Your choice of 3D printer will decide the slicer software you use. A lot of popular FDM printers would allow you to use any slicer that can generate a compatible G-code. For SLA printers, it looks like it's more common to use proprietary slicer software specific to the printer maker. So for my Wanhao Duplicator, I use Ultimaker Courier, which is connected to Octoprint print server installed on Raspberry Pi 4. This is really convenient. For Anycubic Photon Mono 2, I use Anycubic Photon Workshop and just copy files to USB flash drive. Depending on the part you want to print, you might get away with printing on default settings, or you might need to make some changes. You're going to be tweaking things like initial layer temperature for the hot end and the build plate to make sure you have a good adhesion, minimum layer time for smaller parts, support and support settings for the prints that need them, and so on. To see how I make some cool 3D printed robots, check out these two videos. One is about Smarz spider robot, and the other one is about the Dalek with the language model inside.